So this video is intended to show you how much work I expect you to show when you're solving a 3x3 system using Cramer's rule. So the first thing I would expect to see is your coefficient determinant set up. So that would be all your coefficients in a 3x3 determinant. And remember, whenever you're solving Cramer's rule for a 3x3 system or bigger, I'm never going to ask you to do these determinants by hand. So you would pop this into your calculator, use the determinant command, and it would give you 177. And then I would expect you to set up the x determinant, which is the top of the x fraction. And for that, you replace that column of x coefficients in the coefficient determinant with the solutions over here. So this will be 5, 31, and negative 7, and the rest of the determinant would stay the same. If I went in the calculator, I get 5, 31. So x would be 5, 31 over 177, which is 3. So then I'm going to go evaluate the y determinant, which I do by replacing the y coefficients in the coefficient determinant with those solutions. When I evaluate that, it gives me 177. So my y will be that y determinant divided by the coefficient determinant, which is 1. And then for my z determinant, you replace the z coefficients in that original coefficient determinant with those solutions. Oops, 5, 31, negative 7. And when I evaluate that, it gives me 354. And then z would be that determinant divided by the coefficient determinant, which is 2. And then you write your answer as an ordered triple.